I don't think anybody was expecting the news we got today. Just like in the simulation, watch out for those wrist rockets. Let's take a look at the announcement at StarWars.com. During today's Nintendo Direct, Aspyr and Lucasfilm Games revealed Star Wars Battlefront Classic Collection, which will see the beloved Star Wars Battlefront and Star Wars Battlefront 2 introduced to a new generation. Coming March 14th, for Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 5, PlayStation 4, Xbox Series X and S, Xbox One, and PC via Steam for $35 and a penny. The Classic Collection features restored online play for up to 64 players, expansions to Hero Assault Mode, and all previously released bonus content for both titles. Steam users will also enjoy Steam Deck support. Now, in the StarWars.com post, which you can check out yourself at StarWars.com, it tells you everything that you would need to know. I have to wonder, number one, is there going to be enough of a player base that's going to pay $35 for a game that's 20 years old? Is there going to be enough of a player base that you're going to get 64 players in a match? And I just have to wonder, why now? Now, I understand that Aspyr has been porting a lot of the older LucasArts titles over to the newer platforms. And of course, we knew a while back that Aspyr was going to be working on this KOTOR remake, which that kind of isn't happening now. Aspyr was the ones that ported KOTOR over to iOS, did a really good job with it. It looks like there's some updates to the graphics and everything, which is great. And I don't want to rain on anybody's parade. Like, this is awesome. Is this going to appeal to anyone other than those that grew up playing the games? And is it more than just like a nostalgia fest? And while I was excited to see it, like, that was cool to see, there is another issue. In case you're wondering whether or not, whether you own the originals, this is from Kotaku. If you already own the original Battlefront or Battlefront 2 on Xbox or Steam, you'll get a 20% discount when pre-ordering the games. Now, I think it's great that this is even an option, that they're bringing it out on all the platforms. Now, it doesn't say, we haven't confirmed whether it's going to be cross-play supported, like Xbox playing PlayStation playing PC players. There is cross-gen support between PlayStation 4 and 5 and the Xbox Series and the Xbox One. This is kind of a new thing, having a multiplayer supported port come over. If you spend $35 and you start and you get playing online, how soon is it going to take for people to go, I like the newer one better? Like, I'm going to go back to the 2017 Battlefront 2 because that's a little better. That's more modern. This is cool and all. Like, it kind of gins up some excitement for something new to do in Star Wars and to get back online and play the multiplayer experience. But, you know, I play the old one via Steam here on my PC. Am I going to spend $35 to play it online? Like, how much better? The graphics aren't really that much better. They're better resolution, right? It's going to look cleaner than probably the one I have. Is it going to be worth $35 for me to, and how many other people is it going to be worth $35 for to play online? Like, I see a lot of content creators are really excited and they're saying, oh yeah, we're back. Well, sort of. Like, are you going to make player guides for classic Battlefront 1 and 2? Is there that much of an audience for that? Like, that's what I'm wondering. Like, how much content are you going to get out of it? You know, I can go back and watch YouTube videos and see the game being played. There may be some excitement for your streaming communities to get together and hang out and play the classic game. And, you know, it'll be fun for a while. But is that really going to last? How long is that going to last? How well is that going to function? How many PlayStation players are going to go spend $35 in the PS store to play these? It's awesome if you're excited. Have at it, you know. I'm not raining on anybody's parade. I don't think this is bad news. I think this is great news for the Star Wars community in general, the Star Wars gaming community in general. So I'd like to hear who's excited about this, what specifically about this gets you excited? And do you think this is just kind of a, is it just kind of a tease? Like, I don't think it has anything to do with the prospects of any new Battlefront game coming out soon. Again, you can go back and watch my previous video I did about Epic Games and Disney and how that relates to Battlefront 2. And pretty sure I demonstrate that the future of the Battlefront series or the Battlefront title isn't necessarily dependent on Electronic Arts. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments. Good luck, and I'll see you at the rendezvous.